Assalamualaikum dear students. In this lecture, we are starting with the concept of commutation process in a simple for loop DC machine. This topic is very important for learning point of view of electrical machines 1. First of all, we will discuss what is commutation. As we have already discussed, if a wire with proper orientation moves through a magnetic field, a voltage is induced according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. That is, when the loop will rotate inside the magnetic field, here the direction of the magnetic fields is from north to south. When the loop will rotate inside the magnetic field, a voltage will induced in it according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. The total voltage induced in a single loop is E total is equal to 2VBL is equal to 2 pi flux into omega, as we have already derived in the last lecture. This is the called single loop or coil. The voltage across the conductor or segment AB is EAB is equal to VBL, and the voltage across the segment CD or conductor CD is ECD is equal to VBL. The overall voltage produced in a single loop is given by E total is equal to 2VBL. As you can see in this figure, the loop consists of four segments, that is segment AB, segment BC, segment CD and segment DA. The voltage across the segments BC and DA are zero, because in case of segment BC and DA, the direction of the velocity and the direction of the magnetic field both are parallel. In case of parallel, V cross B into L is equal to 0. As we know, E is equal to VBL sin theta. In case of parallel, the angle between V and B will be 0 or 180 degrees. Sin 0 or 180 is 0. That's why voltage across the segments BC and DA are 0. When the loop will rotate inside the magnetic field, the direction of the voltage reverses. That is, when the segment AB becomes under the north pole and segment CD becomes under the south pole, after 180 degree, the voltage across the segments AB and CD reverses its polarity. The resulting E-induced voltage, E total or E-induced, is shown here as a function of the time, as you can see in this figure. The voltage out of the loop is alternating between a constant positive value and a constant negative value, that is AC voltage. This is called the AC voltage. That is, the voltage produced in case of DC generator is AC instead of DC. How can DC machine be modified to produce a DC voltage instead of AC voltage? In DC machine, the output of the generator should be DC instead of AC. So I want to convert this negative half cycle into positive half cycle. That means, if I want to make like this, that is, I want to convert this negative half cycle into positive half cycle. This output is only for one loop. we can convert this negative half cycle into positive half cycle by using a mechanism called commutator. That is, we can convert the negative half cycle into positive half cycle or AC voltage into DC voltages by using a mechanism in DC generator. This mechanism is called commutators. Commutator or commutation is the process of converting the AC voltages and currents in the rotor of a DC machine to DC voltages and currents in its terminals. As you can see in this figure, there are two semicircular conducting segments, that is segment A and segment B, called commutating segments or commutator, are added to the end of the loop, that is segment AB or conductor AB is connected to the commutator segment B, and segment CD or conductor CD is connected to the commutator segment A, as you can see in this figure. When the loop will rotate, the commutator segments A and B will rotate as well, because the points of the loop are connected with the commutator segments A and B. When the loop will rotate inside the magnetic field, the commutator segments will rotate as well. As you can see in this diagram, two fixed contacts called brushes are placed at an angle such that at the instant of the voltage in the loop is zero, the contacts short circuit the two segments. That is, when the segment will rotate inside the DC machine, the brushes are connected across the segments A and B. The brushes are the fixed contacts. The animation of commutations concept is shown in this diagram. As you can see in this diagram, the loop is rotating inside the magnetic field and commutator segments are also rotating with the loop. When the segment AB becomes under the north pole and segment CD becomes under the south pole, the commutator segments A and B also reverses the direction. That is, one side of the loop and other segment is connected to the other side of the loop. When the loop will rotate, the commutator segments will rotate as well. As you can see in this figure, the commutator segments and loops both are rotating. That's why voltage always built in the same direction. This connection switching process is known as commutation. Every time voltage of the loop changes direction, the contacts also switch connections. That is, the commutator segments A and B will also switch the direction with the loop. The contacts also switch connections, and the output of the contacts is always built up in the same way, as you can see in this figure. The output voltage is built in the positive end. As you can see in this figure. Now, the negative cycle is not here in this diagram. That is, by using commutator segments or commutator, we can convert the AC voltages and currents to the router across the router into DC voltages and current. That is, by using the commutator segments, we can convert this AC voltage into DC voltage. As you can see in this figure, the voltage produced by a single loop are varying between 0 and 2 VBI. These voltages are not constant DC voltage. These voltages are called pulsating DC voltages. Now the question is, how can further DC machine be modified to produce a constant DC voltage? So in order to achieve this constant level, we are going to the commutation process in a simple four loop DC machine. That is, now we will increase the number of loops from 1 to 4. As you can see in this figure, we had used the single loop. Now we will increase the number of loops from 1 to 4 and see what will happen to the output DC voltage. The diagram of four loop two pole DC machine is shown here. As you can see in this figure, there are two number of poles. This is the north pole and this is the south pole. And these are the commutator segments. That is, commutator segment A, commutator segment B, commutator segment C, and commutator segment D. There are four commutator segments. Number of commutator segments will be equal to the number of loops. As we have already discussed, commutator segments are used to convert the internal generated AC voltages into DC voltages. In every segment, in every commutator segments, two different loops and will be connected. As you can see in this diagram, there are four loops. These are called the number of loops. There's loop number 1, loop number 2, loop number 3, and this is the loop number 4. As we have already discussed the single loop, the diagram of single loop is shown here. Now there are four number of loops instead of single loop. It will be difficult to show all the four loops in this shape. We can't differentiate the loops. As you can see in this figure, if we draw all the four loops in rectangular form, then we can't differentiate between the loops 1, 2, 3, and 4. It is very difficult. That's why we are showing number of loop in this form, as you can see in this figure. One end or conductor of every loop will be under the north pole, and other end of the loop will be under the south pole. As we have already discussed, as you can see in this figure, this is the single loop. One end of this loop is under the north pole and other end of this loop is under the south pole. It means the angle between the loop, two end of the loop, should be 180 degrees. And as you can see in this diagram, this is the single loop. One end of this loop is under the south pole and other end of this loop is under the north pole. It means every loop, the one end of the every loop should be under the north pole and one end of the every loop should be under the south pole, and angle between the two sides should be 180 degree. Every loop will connect two different segments. As you can see in this figure, every loop, there are two points of the every loop. The one point is called the one, and other end of this loop is called the one prime. That is, let this is the one side of the loop and this is the other side of the loop. Other side of the loop is called one prime and this side is called one. As you can see in this figure, this is the one side of the loop number one and this is the other side of the loop number one called one prime. This is the loop number two. As you can see in this figure, the loop number two, one side of the loop number two is connected in is under the north pole, and other side of the loop number two called two prime is under the south pole. Similarly, loop number 3 and loop number 4 are connected. Loop number 1 stretches between commutator segments A and B. That is, one end of the loop number 1 is connected commutator segment A, and other end of the loop number 1 called prime 1 prime is connected to the other segment B. Similarly, the one end of the loop number 2 is connected to the commutator segment B, the other end of the loop number 2 called 2 prime is connected to the commutator segment C. That is, every loop will connect two different commutator segments. That is, if one end of the loop is connected to the segment A, then next end of the loop can be connected to segment B, C or D. As you can see in this figure, the one end of the loop is connected to the segment B and other end of the loop is connected to the segment A. The ends of the every loop should be connected to two different segments. Pole faces that are curved. As you can see in this figure, pole faces are curved. North and south pole faces are curved to provide uniform flux density everywhere under the pole faces. As you can see in this figure, if the pole faces are curved, then the area between rotor and stator in everywhere in the machine is same. If the area is same, then the reluctance will be same. If the reluctance will be same, then the uniform flux density everywhere under the pole faces. The unprime end of the each loop, one is called the unprimed end of the loop and one dash is called the primed end of the loop. The unprimed end of the every loop is outermost wire in each slot. These points are called slot number of slots. The unprimed end of the each loop, that is loop number one, the unprimed of the point of the loop number one is one, and prime point end of the loop number one is one dash. The unprimed end of each loop is the outermost wire in each slot. The primed end, 4 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash and 3 dash end of each loop is the innermost wire in the slot directly opposite. That is, angle between the 1 and 1 prime is 180 degree. The resulting voltage diagram on the rotor conductors of a 4 loop 2 pole DC machine is shown in this figure. As you can see in this figure, this is the loop number 1, this is the loop number 2, this is the loop number 3, and this is the loop number 4. This is the one end of the loop, this is the other end of the loop called 1 prime. The voltage produced across the one end or conductor of the loop is VBL. E is equal to VBL. The voltage produced across the other end of the loop is also VBL. The overall voltage produced in a single loop is 2 VBL. As you can see in this figure, the voltage produced across the conductor or segment AB is VBL, and the voltage produced across the conductor or segment CD is also VBL. The overall voltage produced in a single loop is 2 VBL or 2E. Similarly, loop number 2, the voltage produced across the one end of the loop is E, the other end of the loop is also E. The overall voltage produced across the loop 2 is 2 VBL or 2E. Similarly, loop number 3 and loop number 4. The winding diagram of this machine is shown here. As you can see in the previous diagram, there are 4 commutator segments, and these commutator segments are connected with the loops. When the loop will rotate, the commutator segments will rotate as well. It means the commutator segments A, B, C, D, after 360 degree, then again the commutator segments start from the commutator segment A, B, C, and D. As you can see in this figure, the commutator segments A, B, C, D, and after 360 degree of rotation, then again the commutator segments start from commutator segment A, B, C, and D. There are 4 number of loops, as we have already discussed. If one end of the loop is under the north pole, the other end of the loop should be under the south pole. And also, if one end of the loop is connected to commutator segment A, then other end of the loop will not connect it to the same segment. Instead of, can connect to any other commutator segments. There are 4 number of loops. When the loop will rotate, then the commutator segments will rotate as well. And loops will rotate loop number 1, then loop number 2, loop number 4, and then loop number 4. After this, again start from loop number 1, loop number 2, loop number 3, and loop number 4. As you can see in this figure, there are 2 number of poles. This is the north pole and this is the south pole. And this is the loop number 1. As you can see in this figure, one end of the loop called 1 is under the north pole and is connected to the commutator segment A. The other end of the same loop called 1 prime is under the south pole and connected to the commutator segment B. Similarly, the one end of the loop number 2 is under the north pole and is connected to the segment D. The other end of the loop number 2 is 2 prime under the south pole and is connected to the commutator segment C. When the loops will rotate, the commutator segments will rotate as well. And here is the number of brushes. The brushes are the fixed contacts in any machine. This is called the winding diagram of 4 loop 2 pole DC machine. Now we will discuss what will happen when the 4 loops, that is loop number 1, 2, 3, and 4, will rotate inside the magnetic field. That is, how much voltage will be produced due to these 4 loops. start from omega t is equal to 0 degree, that is at this position, when loops will rotate, as you can see in this figure, the one end of the loop number 1 and one end of the loop number 2 and the 3 prime of the loop number 3 and 4 prime of the loop number 4 are under the north pole faces, and the voltage induced in each of the loop end is given by E is equal to VBL, that is the voltage produced across the one end of the loop number 1 is E is equal to VBL. The voltage produced across the one end of the loop number 2 is also VBL. The voltage across the loop number 3, one end of the loop number 3 is also VBL, and the voltage across the one end of the loop number 4 is also VBL. The overall voltage will produce under the north pole faces are is equal to E is equal to 4 VBL is equal to 4 E, as you can see in this figure. Similarly, the point 1 prime, 2 prime, 3 and 4 ends of the loops are under the south pole face, and the voltage induced in each of the loop is given by E is equal to VBL. The overall voltage will produce under the south pole faces will be E is equal to 4 VBL, that is equal to 4 E. The voltage diagram of this the position is shown here. As you can see in this figure, the overall voltage produced across the brushes of this machine is E is equal to 4 E. The parallel path of the current will depend on the number of brushes. Here the number of brushes are 2, that is in this machine the parallel path of the current are 2. The existence of 2 or more parallel paths for rotor current is a common feature of all commutation schemes. Now we will discuss what happens to the voltage E of the terminals as the rotor continues to rotate inside the magnetic field or through the magnetic fields. Let now the omega t is equal to 45 degree. In this case, that is when the loop 1 and 3 will rotate 45 degree, then what happens to the voltage E of the terminals as the rotor rotate? Now as you can see in this figure, when the loop 1 and 3 will move 45 degree, that is omega t is equal to 45 degree, loop number 2 and 4 will also move 45 degree further. As you can see in this figure, loop number 1 and loop number 3 have rotated in the air gap. This is the air gap, this is also the air gap between the poles. That is, loop number 1 and 3 are rotated between the air gaps between the two poles. That is, this is the north pole and this is the south pole. So the voltage across each of them, that is loop number 1 and loop number 3, will be 0. That is, at this position, the rotation, the velocity of the rotor and the direction of the magnetic fields both are parallel. In case of parallel, as we have already discussed, in case of parallel V and B, the voltage across produce will be 0. At this instant, when the loop 1 and 3 becomes the air gap between the north and south pole, at instant the brushes of the machine are shortening out commutator segments A, B and CD. Now you can see in this figure only two loops, loop number 2 and loop number 4, are under the pole faces. Loop number 2 and 4 dash are under the north pole face. 2 dash and 4 ends of the loop are under the south pole face. And you can see in this figure loop number 1 and 3 are not under the pole faces. That's why the voltage produced across the loop number 1 and 3 will be 0. Now the voltage across the, as we know, the voltage across the single end of the loop is E is equal to VBL. Now you can see in this figure there are two ends of the loops are under the north pole. That is, the overall voltage will produce is E is equal to 2VBL is equal to 2E. Similarly, as you can see here, the two ends of the loop number 2 and 4 are under the south pole. The voltage produced across the single end of the loop is E is equal to VBL, and the voltage across produced across the two ends of the loops will be E is equal to 2E, or E is equal to 2VBL. The voltage diagram is shown here. The overall voltage will produce when the loops will rotate omega t is equal to 45 degree. The overall voltage will produce across the fourth loop will be E is equal to 2E. Now we will discuss what happens to the voltage E when the rotor continues to turn another 45 degree, that is omega t is equal to 90 degree instead of 45 degree. That is, now we will discuss what happens to the voltage E when the loop 1 and 3 will rotate further 45 degree. When the loop 1 and 3 will rotate further 45 degree, and loop number 2 and 4 will also rotate the 45 degree. The diagram of four loop two pole DC machine at omega t is equal to 90 degrees shown here. Now as you can see in this figure, when the loop 1 and 3 will rotate 45 degree further, that is at omega t is equal to 90 degree, now the loop 1 and 3, one end of the loop 3 will become under the north pole phase. At the start, at omega t is equal to 0, the one end of the loop 1 and 3 are under the south pole phase. After 90 degree, these points become under the north pole phases. Now as you can see in this figure, the 1 dash, 2, 3 and 4 dash ends of the loop are under the north pole phase, and the voltage in each of the loop's ends is given by E is equal to VBL. That is, the voltage across the one end of the loop number 1 called 1 prime is VBL, and the voltage across the one end of the loop number 2 called 2 is also VBL. The voltage due to one end of the loop number 3 is also VBL, and the voltage across the one end of the loop number 4 called 4 prime is also VBL. The overall voltage across the four ends of the loops which are under the north pole faces is E is equal to, is given by E is equal to 4 VBL is equal to 4 E. As we know, E is equal to VBL, putting the value of E in this equation, we get E is equal to, E capital is equal to 4 E small. Similarly, as you can see in this figure, the 1, 2 dash, 3 dash and 4 ends of the loops are under the south pole phase, and the voltage in each of the loop ends is given by VBL. The overall voltage will produce under the south pole phase is given by E is equal to 4E. The voltage diagram at omega t is equal to 90 degree is shown here. The overall voltage will produce when the four loops will rotate at omega t is equal to 90 degree. The overall voltage is given by across the brushes of this machine is given by E is equal to 4E. As you can see in this figure, at the start, the ends of the loop number 1 and 3, that is 3 and 1 prime, are under the south pole phase. After 90 degree, the ends of the loop 1 prime and 3 are under the north pole phases, that is have reversed between omega t is equal to 0 degree and omega t is equal to 90 degree, but their connections also reversed, as you can see in this figure. Hence, the total voltage is still built up in the same direction as before. The resulting terminal voltage E as a function of time is shown here, as we have already found. At omega t is equal to 0 degree, the overall voltage is given by E is equal to 4E, and after 45 degree, that is at omega is equal to 45 degree, after the rotation of 45 degree, that is at omega, at time omega t is equal to 45 degree, the overall voltage is given by E is equal to 2E. And again at time omega t is equal to 90 degree, again the voltage is given by E is equal to 4E. That, as you can see in this figure, the voltages are now varying from 4E to 2E. In case of loop number 1, the voltages was 0 at some point of the, or at some angle of the angle, but here the voltage is not, the voltages are not 0. This is a better approximation to a constant DC level than that produced by a single rotating loop. As the number of loops on the rotor increases, the approximation to a perfect DC voltage gets better and better. We can improve the further constant DC voltage by increasing the number of loops from 4 to 8 to 10, 20, 30, 40 or 100. By increasing the number of loops, the difference between the highest voltage and lowest voltage will be minimum, and at the end we can get a pure DC voltage. That is, by increasing the number of loops, we can convert the pulsating DC voltage into pure DC voltage. In summary, the internal generated voltage of the AC machine is, of the DC generator is AC voltage. At the start, the voltage is AC. To convert the AC voltages into DC voltages, we use a mechanism called commutator or commutator segments. By using commutator segments, we can convert AC voltages and currents into DC voltage or current across the router. This is the pulsating DC voltage. To convert the pure DC voltage, by increasing the number of loops, we can convert the pulsating DC voltage into pure DC voltage or currents. As you can see in this figure, we can further improve, that is, we can get a constant DC voltage, that is a straight line, by increasing the number of loops from 4 to 6 to 10 to 20 or 1000 or 100. Commutation is the process of switching the loop connections on the router of a DC machine, just as the voltage in the loop switches polarity, in order to maintain as necessary constant DC output voltage. Commutation segments. Rotating segments to which the loops are attached, typically made of copper bars. Brushes, as you can see in this figure, stationary pieces that ride on the top of the moving segments. On the top of the moving segments, typically made up of a mixture containing graphite, so that they cause very little friction. In the next lecture, we will discuss the different types of winding.